So I just decided to make a top-down shooter game, both to have more content on my channel as well as to get the extra practice from it. I have not yet made anything like this. The only thing I did up to this point is an adventure game engine for text adventures and a turn-based roguelike with both very bare bones. Very basic, so I have not made any real-time game yet. So I think this will be an interesting new challenge. I don't know if it will be a challenge because it's a very simple thing and I won't make it too complex, but it will of course be a new thing, a very interesting new thing. So I've already created this new project, the top-down shooter. But we will not start here, we will actually start in Paint, creating a mind map for what will be included in this game. I think Paint is a very nice tool to create mind maps. It can't do much, but things it can do, it can do really well. So you can easily resize your picture, you can zoom in and out really easily. And you can create really simple shapes and everything without needing to be good at anything art related. So we will start top-down shooter. Something like this. Let's make this also a bit bigger. It's a heading. It can be bigger and underlined. And also thing Paint does really good is that you can just drag everything around like this without creating new layers for everything. So we've got our top-down shooter. Actually, let me get this module in the middle. I don't know if we will have a lot of things, but if we do, we will need this extra space. So of course our main node is the player. Make this smaller again. Player, there will be enemies, and the player will have guns. No, oh, wrong tool. Player will have guns, and yeah, there will be levels. Probably only one, maybe more. The thing about levels is that they, as long as you don't introduce new mechanics, as long as you are not about seriously making a game, if you're just after your packs, there's levels don't add much. They are basically usually just creating new maps with the same stuff, and they teach you game design and level design. But that's not what I'm here for. I want to get the extra practice for programming, and I want to get how to I want to get more fluent in the programming part, as you could say. So I also just recycled my tile set for the roguelike edit, and I might have to do new assets, and I will happily take you through that process as well. But yeah, just let us continue with the mind map planning part at the beginning. May also connect these with lines. Always looks nice. So, let's have at least two kinds of enemy, namely melee and ranged. The movement will be probably the string stick thing, so WASD and the mouse. I think I also want to give the player some special abilities because I also never did that, and the more things you learn, the better. Yeah, so like this. Yeah, what could they be? Let's Just take anything I dash. It's always interesting. And a grenade. For the weapons, I think I also only want to have two weapons to not make it too complicated. So what are they called? Rifles. Yeah, basic rifle to start, and I probably do want to have weapon pickups as well to have that. I have done that at some point. Let's make the other thing a rifle fires fast small projectiles, so the obvious contrast would be something small as something firing in single shots that deal a lot of damage or something. You may notice I've not done this a lot before. I could do a rocket launcher, but we already have grenades. A flamethrower. They are not what I just described, but they're cool. And they are mechanically a lot different from other guns. Levels, yeah, multiple rooms. Yeah, something rewarding for the player. I actually want this to be fun, I just don't want it to be super fleshed out and super time consuming. So let's just add something like a high score mechanic. Score points. They should have. I think they should be dropped by enemies. Melee ranged enemies, and they all drop score points. Levels have multiple rooms. Open rooms and corridors. So, do we need anything more? I don't think we need anything more, so I will just leave this at is, and if I get any new ideas, I will add them to this. Let's just save it under the this one. Yeah, mindmap.png. And I think it's really important to have something like this to keep you in scope and to not firstly, you don't want to get overwhelmed by ideas and try to implement everything. If you try to do that, you will never actually finish the game. So this will keep you in scope. Also, it will prevent you from ever having a phase where you don't know what to add. You know it's very incomplete, but you don't know what to add either. So here you already know what to add. And what not to add is even more important. And as I said, if there are any really good new ideas, you can always add them to this. So, save this and jump into Godot. Yeah, so I created a new level plane, a level node actually. So we will do a basic level on this. I will not explain anything Godot related here. I will just assume you know everything, and this is also not a tutorial as well. I don't really care if you I don't really care if you know anything about this UI. Let's get a tile set node. A tile map is it actually. And import a tile set that I have Yeah, it has said that I have just cloned from the from my actual main project. And this does not look that's okay, good. Okay. So we'll have to make some adjustments. They're 16 by 16. And now it works. Great. Just draw a basic room. Like this. With some walls. I'm trying way too hard on this one. I should not do this. Just let it as it is. It's really just a dummy scene. Level building. I can do proper level building later. So now we have a starting position and a basic level. Let's see. We'll first save this. Scenes for level is fine. And then go on this one, new scene, player, Rigid Body 2D, I think it was, no, Kinematic Body. Actually, I actually don't really know what to do for this. I just do what I have seen in some tutorials or the Gitto docs being used commonly. I don't really know if we actually need what I will take. I just know it will work with what node I take, so that's enough for me for this. So, kinematic body. I don't think we need a kinematic body. I think this is only if we would use gravity, which we won't. Anyhow, yes, this had no shape. We need a collider, no? A collision collision shape, which can be. Let's first also add a sprite. We need an animated sprite. Yeah, I think so. We'll take this one. Frames. With this one. Would have to slice the picture up beforehand, so I will take a sprite. Just load the texture in from the sprites player idle, and first configure this one. It has three horizontal frames, and it is. Loaded from an atlas. It is 16 by 16 pixels large. And I've done something wrong. Okay. I don't know what. It's three horizontal frames. Oh. Yeah. I know what it's reveal. We of course have to tell Godot the total size of the atlas, not of one tile. Otherwise it won't know what size the atlas is. Oh, it's just three, not 16. So we have this little guy, then we can create a collision shape for him. It's a rectangle. Just shape it roughly like guy. We'll probably. For a turn-based, tile-based game, we would not need a collider. I think for this one, we actually do. We will also need to attach a script to the player, create. Let's actually Create an organizational node. Game. Make this the scene root. And attach a main script. This one. So, yeah, we have now. We can need to. We have to do a player controller here. I hope you can't hear my keyboard, and if you can, it's not too loud. If so, I will try to fix it for the next video. Yeah, player controller here. This video is already a while, so I will probably introduce a cut very soon, but let's just make a few basic things now. So, yeah, up, down, left, right. Up is W, down is S, left is A, right is of course D. So, oh, that's not everything. We will need to include everything from here into the actual actions here. So, we will need a shoot action, we will need a weapon switch, a weapon down and weapon up. Because I will use the mouse wheel to switch to scroll through weapons. This is not super important for two weapons, but if we would add an entire arsenal, it would be important. Grenade. What's also the WASD mouse? Yeah, abilities. Dash. Oh. We could use an alternate fire, but I don't think we will, and if we will, we can still add this later, so that's fair enough. Mouse button, left button, down. Wheel up. This is the down. So this one. And oh no, no key. A mouse button. No, wheel up. Grenade. We will use good old G key. And for dash, shift will do. Yeah, shift is always a good dash button. We can already write the first lines of code, and then it will add a cut. So we will just call this player controller. And you see, it's really just doing something to get started. You don't actually need to know a lot about what you are doing. You can just do something, write everything that comes to your mind in this mind map, and then doing one thing after another, or do them randomly. Although I would not recommend doing them randomly. I will now focus. Yeah, a little bit random in both level and player, do them parallel. But I will keep enemies for after I finish those two. And I will first start with creating the basic controls and then the rest. I will not make the game super fancy right now. And that's really important, I think, that you keep focused and not do just do anything or something. Then you will quickly get demotivated. So, to create a function named player controller, you don't need to know what you are doing. You just need to know how to define a function, and that's not hard if you read the Godot docs introduction to scripting. You know how that works, and I really recommend you do if you want to develop anything with Godot. So, yeah, I do actually know how to add input to our player controller, but for the sake of this video, just to demonstrate how I do this, let's assume I wouldn't. So I would go into Godot docs, search for input, and just look through this list of things, of functions, of pre-built functions, what would work for getting input. Or alternatively, if there's if I don't find anything like this, we can just go into Google and say, in my case, DuckDuckGo, and say Godot track user in easier. They try to stay really simple with this. Input keys. How to enter input in Godot, this sounds good. Or even better, if there's a Godot docs link, I would always use this. Even if you previously did not find anything here in this by searching manually, this might just be because you had searched poorly or something. If Google recommends you something like this, I would prefer the official Godot docs. Although in this case it's actually not what I want. This would totally work by the way. We could just use how the input event this suggests to us, but we won't. There's another way I prefer, and then I think that it's generally better. Okay, none of these are actually suggesting what I would do, and what I would do. Once again, I'm not an expert. All these ways might be better. I don't know. But in the step-by-step manual in your first game, there was actually they created the player inputs this way, and that's how we will do this right now. So just let's just copy this because we're lazy. Programmers are lazy, always. So you're not an exception. I bet you're lazy. Yeah, let's just start by direction. Yeah, let's just make the directional input things first. So up, down, left, right, and these are just the keys we set up and the project settings here. Once again, nothing fancy. And once again, we will do the same thing as the tutorial here says. We'll just add a variable. Velocity is fine. Velocity. 0, let's put the 0. This should. Where is the 0? I think. Yeah, it should be at vector 2. With 0, 0. And speed is something else. No. And it shouldn't be a var either, it should be a constant. And this will need to be a lot higher than 1, I just don't know how much. And the reason we need speed is because if you see, Godot actually measures its 2D in pixels, so if we will have the speed to 1, our player character will always move 1 pixel at a time, and as you might get this pretty slow. We don't want that. And the velocity, on the other hand, is just the direction the player is going on. We'll call this direction. The way we will now just implement this button presses doing something is just to direction dot y, because it's up and down, plus equals 1. Yep, plus, no, in Godot it's actually minus, because Godot increases its, or any computer system, any screen extends its y coordinates downwards, so they get higher the further down you go. So direction dot y plus 1. Direction dot x minus 1. And direction dot x plus 1. So for this you of course need to know something. You need to know how to do this, but once again you can just Google it. Anyway, that's this for the first part of the series. I at least hope this will become a series and I will not give up now, but I'm pretty confident it will. I will continue. And I also hope this video was less terrible than my last one, just for quality. Bye.